everyone. In this video, you will learn how to configure workflows to trigger actions based on user's input in a form in Zoho Creator. The onUser input of a field is a field rule in Zoho Creator that lets you execute actions based on the data entered by the user. In this way, forms can be made dynamic to give varied responses for different data entry. Let's take the case of an order management application to understand this functionality better. This is a sample app for a home appliance store. Customers can place their order by filling in this form. Let the requirement here be to give a 10% discount on all orders above $300. We can define a workflow to automatically apply the discount when the order total exceeds $300 in the net total field. To do this, go to the editor and select the workflow section. All the form workflows configured so far can be seen listed here. Click New Workflow. On the screen that appears, choose the form in which you want to trigger the workflow. Let's choose the order form. We want the discount to be shown when the form is created as well as edited, so let's choose that. We need user input of a field as our form event since the requirement can only be met with based on total amount. Specify the field based on which the discount should be activated. Since grand total is a formula field that gets auto-populated, users won't have access to enter data in it. Hence, we'll use the quantity field as the total amount depends on the number of products we choose. Give a name and click Create Workflow. Now that the workflow is created, let's add the required action to it. The action is to ensure that a discount of 10% is applied to all orders above $300. This can be executed only with the help of Dilute script. This is the Dilute script builder. Let's write a script here. The 10% discount is given to all orders above $300. First, we need to declare a variable for the values in the grand total field. Let's say amount equals input.grandTotal semicolon. Now, we have a condition to execute here. Whenever there is a condition based on which an action has to take place, we choose conditional statements. We have only one condition, so let's choose if. You can either drag and drop or directly type on the builder. Give the condition if amount greater than 300. Now, specify the action to be executed when the condition is met. We need the net total field to populate a value after deducting 10% from the total amount. Type input.netTotal equals amount minus amount multiplied by 1 by 10, semicolon. Here, we have used the arithmetic operations to make the calculation. Let's save the code and access the application to see what happens. Let's make an order such that the total amount exceeds $300. As you can see, the net total field has populated a value after deducting 10% from the total amount. You can configure many such workflows on user's input for various requirements. For instance, this code written in an HR management application ensures that whenever the date of birth added by the employee succeeds the current date, an alert message pops up. Similarly, this is an IT asset tracker application where based on the chosen value, fields are hidden as well as shown. Zoho Creator provides a code-free workflow to do the same. Check out our video to learn more about this. However, when you have multiple fields to hide or show, time can be saved by writing a code. In this order management application, the code has been written based on the value entered in the subtotal and tax fields. As per the condition, when both the fields are not empty, the tax percentage is calculated and added to the subtotal to get the net total. In this way, you can easily execute actions based on the user's input in a field. Hope this video helped you in understanding the entire procedure better. That's all for now. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to learn more about Zoho Creator and press the bell icon to get notified whenever a new video releases. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.